old faces, new places, guys getting it done. How about Max Domi? Has that ever fit in well in Montreal? Mike Hoffman, 16-game point streak extended the other night. Elias Lindholm, he's fitting in well with his new squad, 11 goals, 11 helpers. Ryan O'Reilly getting it done in St. Louis right now, 10 goals, 13 assists in 19 games. And how about Jeff Skinner in Buffalo, the Sabres, who have won six in a row. Skinner's got 14 goals, and things are all good right now in Buffalo. Let's start with Mike Hoffman. 16-game point streak for a Panthers team who certainly had high expectations coming into the season. Maybe the team hasn't lived up to those expectations, but you can't point the finger at Mike Hoffman. Did you think this was going to work out this well going
in? Not this well, but I knew it was going to be good because this guy could fire peas. He shoots bullets. He's been great for them. I saw him Sunday at Madison Square Garden for the Florida Panthers. This guy is passing the puck better than he ever has. He's known for that trademark shot, but he's been great for them, Hartsey.
Yeah, he puts himself in some great positions, gets it off quick. That's how you score goals, catching the goalie off guard, making sure he's not set. He's just firing away.
Mm-hmm. How about a guy like Max Domi? You talk about wanting the spotlight. You go to Montreal. You play at Bell Center. This guy is thriving in that environment under that microscope. Why do you think?
Yeah, a lot of his goals, he's carrying the puck through the neutral zone. He's going full tilt. Making some good moves, obviously, before he shoots, a couple backhand goals. He's doing it all. And for him to take the next step in his career, this is probably the best thing for him, getting out of Phoenix, going here, having a fresh start.
No doubt. Look at these numbers.
1-1-1-1-1.
Historic start, too, for any player.
Yeah.
For the Montreal Canadiens.
Yeah,
wow. Historic start. Best left winger in the league right now, the way he's playing. All-star.
Right. How about Jeff Skinner in Buffalo? Ooh. Six in a row for the Sabres. As I'm talking about playoffs
exactly.
Up there in Buffalo
yeah.
Right now.
We're loving that.
On Chippewa Street.
That's Super. Right. What are you doing? Oh, boy, James.
Have you ever been there,
Chippewa Street in Buff?
Yeah. The Chop House
great.
In Buffalo?
Yeah, the Chop House is a good
Delicious.
Spot upstairs. He's been great for them, though.
This guy can obviously shoot the puck. He can skate, too. Great on his edges. Loves to go to the net, too. Not the biggest guy, but when you put yourself in front of that net with his hands, he's going to bury him.
All right, so how about Elias Lindholm? That was the trade on draft day, swapping places. He joins that top line in Calgary. And if there's two guys you want to play with, it's Johnny Gaudreau and Sean Monahan. Talk about what Elias Lindholm is doing right now and for the Flames.
He's making plays. He fit in seamlessly on that line. Ferland was a guy who's been really good in Carolina and created space on this top line. But Lindholm, just from a pure skill standpoint, has been a perfect fit for them.
Yeah, hitting the jackpot playing with Gaudreau. the passes that he can make, you put yourself in some positions and you get that puck off your stick, you're going to have obviously a good start, which he has, and the Flames are playing awesome.
All right, not the best of starts in St. Louis, but Ryan O'Reilly, he got off to a slow start, but he's starting to heat it up. Coaching change, as we mentioned. Why do you think Ryan O'Reilly's been such a good fit there for the Blues?
Just a gritty guy. He's not the smoothest of skaters, I guess you could say. He probably doesn't like hearing that, but look at the smile on his face after he's scoring the toothless, bearded wonder there. And, you know, he'll be a big part of that. Hopefully St. Louis can turn it around.
Complete player, playing all situations. Really improved his offensive game the last few years, but a very complete player, two-way player, dependable.
All right,
it's been
one,
good.
First, second, first. So Ryan O'Reilly, these are old faces, new places, getting it done. Let's go to your wheelhouse.
What?
Between the pipes.
Oh.
How about a pair of goalies who are in new locations, but certainly having outstanding seasons at the quarter mark. Yaro Halak in Boston and Carter Hutton getting the majority of the starts up there for the red-hot Buffalo Sabres. The Bees are certainly happy to have Halak because Tuukka Rask leaving to take some time off there, coming back, but this guy has been outstanding between the pipes. Why?
I love Halak, the way he's played at Boston. He's had an excellent career. He's had a really good career. Coming to Boston, he helped stabilize things. You can allow Tuukka to get a little time to get healthy, to get right. Halak has been absolutely sensational for them.
Yeah, just a goalie that's been around the league. He's traveled to a few teams and when his number's called, he's going in there and playing well.
Yeah, no doubt, no doubt.
And how about the curious case of Carter Hutton?
Oh.
What do you think about him? Just, you know, you don't always know how that's going to play out when you go from
money.
Maybe 1B to 1A, but he has been cash money.
He's been cash money. I asked him last weekend. I said, hey, what's the biggest thing for you? He said, you know what? I just go out and play my game. We got a good group in here. Well, presto changeo. He's been great. He's wanted to be a one. He's a one right now.
And he's playing like it, that's right? For sure. Guys, I've loved him in Nashville from what I've heard about him. A great guy. You want to play harder for a great goaltender behind you. So,
no doubt.
Good story there. And look at that.
Last five games, team that's won six.
Hello.
In a row. Carter Hutton getting it done. The goals against average under 2, .936 save percentage.